Hi, I'm Saverio from HoRNet Plugins. Today we are going to show you our new plugin, the ELM128. It's a loudness meter, very useful to measure the loudness of your tracks and of your program in general, that complies with the EBU R128 standard. It's a very recent standard designed to be used in broadcasting. It's meant to be some kind of reference to be used to make sure that every thing in the same program, the same television transmission, is at the same level. They decided to make this standard after the problem with commercial being louder than the program, for example. But it's very useful on audio production, because very recently YouTube started using something very similar to this. And if your tracks are too squashed, are too compressed to make them louder, as we used during the loudness wars of the recent years, your tracks probably won't sound very good on YouTube. I have prepared a couple of examples here to show you how this meter can help you with an overly loud track and one that is very lower in volume. This meter shows you the loudness, the momentary loudness that is referred to the last 400 milliseconds of program, the short-term loudness that is 3 seconds, the integrated loudness, it's the loudness of the overall time when the meter was active, the loudness range expressed in loudness units that in this case are equivalent to decibels. So if you see 10 here, you see that it means that on the between the loudest part and the softer part there are 10 dB of difference. And the true peak in decibel full scale, the true peak is the real peak of the signal, because it takes into consideration intersample peaks, something that regular digital peak meter doesn't do, because they need to be oversample at least four times to do that. In addition to these metering features, you can pause the meter while it's running, reset it, and normalize to the EBU reference of minus 23 loudness units. This has been chosen as a reference because it's loud enough, but not too much loud, and it's perfect for being transmitted over the air. But let's start seeing how this works with the first very loud signal. You see, this is a very loud signal here, which in the momentary loudness section, which that is topping of most of the time. The short term shows that it's very loud, it's minus 12. Integrated is minus 12. We have a very short loudness range, very small. And the true peak shows that it's peaking at the top, the maximum possible digital level. So, what we are gonna do now, we are gonna use our normalization feature to bring it down to minus 23. So I start the meter again, reset it. Okay, here we see that the normalization feature has tried to lower the volume until it reaches the target of minus 23 loudness units. and it's slowly going there. This is because we have two parallel processing units in this plugin. One that is one with the gain resulting from the normalization procedure applied, and the other one analyzing the signal as it is. And so the difference is computed, and every moment the gain is adjusted so that the integrated loudness falls around minus 23, that is the hotspot we are trying to achieve. The loudness range is still very small, but because the signal is compressed in the first place, so if we wanted a wider loudness range, we should have used less compression during the mixdown. The true peak is now much smaller, and it's more manageable for transmitting over the air. Let's go to the other track, the low level one. I reset the meter. It's now reading zero everywhere. This is a much lower volume track. This track is much lower in volume, it makes barely move the loudness, momentary loudness meter, and it's very low here, as you can see in the other metering. So I will reset the normalization feature, start it again with it, turn it on, and we will see that the gain will be increased. In this case too, we see that the normalization tried to increase the gain to bring it up to minus 23, it's sitting here around. And we see the integrated loudness is now minus 22.7, so we are almost there. The normalization works in real time, so we can change from one track to the other, and it will try to keep the gain, the integrated loudness at the same level. So with this meter, you also have the chance to normalize the gain on the fly. It can be used in live situations, so I think it, with a little bit of attention paid to it, can be very useful for live broadcasting situation. This is HoRNet ELM128. It's available on hornetplugins.com. You can go there and try out the plugin. We don't provide a demo for that because it doesn't affect the sound. But if you don't like it, you can have your money back. So go there, download it, let us know. Thank you for watching.